In this video, we'll be discussing our new metric called Vanna Inertia. The Vanna Inertia metric can be defined as a bullish or bearish inequality as a result of equal notional capital applied to the underlying. Another way of looking at it is the imbalance of results from bullish or bearish activity that is outside the dealer purview. This metric can be used as a complement to dealer hedging required to balance their books. So right now, as an example on SPX, we have a Vanna inertia of -0.5. This means that if there were a coin flip catalyst where it's a 50-50 chance of upside or downside, the downside risk in price exceeds the upside reward by roughly 2-to-1. 3-to-1 would be about -0.75, et cetera, et cetera. So this uses a kind of complex thermodynamics method of calculation. I'm going to show this visually. First, this is calculated only on the plus or minus 5% of the current price, because there are not many customers out there that will single-handedly move the market 5%. Although, considering NVIDIA moves recently, I can question that premise pretty easily, but I digress. Second, this is real-time based on all expiration Vanna. And third, this assumes that dealers want negative Vega to warehouse and collect their theta. So let's look at this SPX example. I am going to zoom in first to the 5% of the current price. Current price is 54.69. So that's about 275 points on either side. So 275, that's right about here. So that's 51.95. That's about right there. And we also have on the upside 57.45. So that's right about here. Maybe we can zoom in or go like this just a little bit. Okay. This is essentially the cumulative chart that we are going to be working with. First, let's look on the top side. Remember, as a review, Vanna can be defined as the change in Vega based on movements in the underlying. So Vanna can increase Vega if the price goes up based on this movement here. So looking at this chart now, this area right here would be bullish because this is reducing the Vega as price increases. But once you get past this 5,500 right here, it can get very bearish. This whole area right here. Meanwhile, on the downside, we could see it's pretty neutral until you get to this number right here. This would be bearish because it is relieving dealers of Vega. They want to see these negative numbers right here. Now, because it is not just a sharp downturn like this, that would be more bearish because the immediate move would be straight down to here. Okay. So essentially, what we're doing is we're comparing bullish mass and the bearish mass versus the possible bullish mass versus bearish mass. So if the price looked like this, then we would have a full red rectangle right here, and the Vanna inertia would be very, very low. However, typically when we see SPX, Vanna looks like this, and it's a big V. That would make this section right here, conceivably, bullish, because it is supporting on the way down. Vega would have to go up if the market goes down, and dealers don't want that necessarily, so their hedges would reflect support in that scenario. This is a visual reference to show you what the Vanna inertia is all about. The growth pace of these respective masses aggregated make the total Vanna inertia figure. The point of this whole metric is to try to help measure the extra dealer flow impact on the underlying price. For the dealer flow, you just use the aggregate Vanna notional, and you can use the trend on the aggregate trend widget. If you use the Vanna inertia and aggregate Vanna together, it'll give you a full picture of plausible return profile, and it'll inform your trade planning. It will give you the risk that you should be most willing to accept. As a side note, I included over here this gamma curve because we are in the middle of, currently in SPX, the price is in the middle of a lot of dealer long calls, customer short calls. And that's reflected in the gamma That's very, very positive, and it will not go negative for a long time. I just wanted to express that this is kind of showing how Vanna is a bit more important than Gamma when determining the extra dealer flow. The GEX Gamma exposure people will identify this as positive Gamma, positive Gamma, positive Gamma. Meanwhile, what we're seeing from the Vanna is that this is a very bearish current term. Thank you for watching this video. And may Volland help you in your trading ventures.